In the last session, we discussed about the overview of Snowflake. In this session, let's understand Snowflake by its definition. Snowflake is an analytics data warehouse provided as a software as service known as SaaS. Snowflake provides a data warehouse that is faster, easier to use, and far more flexible than traditional data warehouse offerings. Snowflake is providing such functionalities because of its additional offerings that it is providing, which is not there in the traditional data warehouses. Snowflake has a different architecture as well as compared to traditional data warehouse. I hope that you are equally excited to learn as much as I am excited to teach this course. Let's move forward to access Snowflake account. So Snowflake provides 30 days free trial to access, and let's learn how to create a free Snowflake trial account. Now to access free Snowflake trial account, you have to go to your browser and type create Snowflake trial account. By right typing this, you will get the first link, which will be trial.snowflake.com. Access this first link and you will be landed here. So this page provides several keys to be entered by the user to create a free Snowflake trial account. So I'm entering my name. I'm skipping this. My country is India. So fill out these details and continue. Once you have clicked on continue by filling all the details on the first page of create free trial account, you must be landed here. So here it says start your 30 days free trial and receive $400 free usage with sign up. Now we have three options to choose the Snowflake edition. So standard, it has some limitations to as per the standard edition of Snowflake account. Then we come to enterprise, which provides some additional functionality such as 90 day time travel and multi cluster data warehouses. We will discuss about these later. So for now, let's click on business critical so that we get all the functionalities that is there on Snowflake account, and we will learn everything that is there. Now there is another thing to be chosen by the user, which is cloud provider. So Snowflake has tie-ups with these three providers, which is AWS, Amazon Web Services, second is GCP, which is Google Cloud Platform, and third is provided by Microsoft, which is Microsoft Azure. So for now, we will access AWS, and we are choosing this cloud provider because all the data that you will be creating will be stored on AWS. So now you have to click the region. So you have to be very critical while choosing this region, because this region will be accessed on your AWS warehouses. All the data that is stored on AWS will be in this region itself. So if you want to do some projects with AWS and on Snowflake, so you have to be very critical while choosing this region. So currently I am choosing US East Northern Virginia, and will supply my phone number and we'll get started. So let's do this. You are landed to this page, but note in the previous page you had to enter the phone number including your country code. Okay, so now we are on this page and it is written that account setup is in progress. So let's give it some time and get back. After a couple of minutes, you are on this screen where it is showing you are now signed up, and now you have to check your email to activate your trial account and start using Snowflake. So go to your email account from which you have registered to Snowflake, and here you will see an email from Snowflake. Open it, and there are some details which needs to be noted. So here it says congratulations on taking the first step to become a data driven etc. So let's ignore this. So the important thing is click to activate. This is the first. This is the important step that we have to take to access Snowflake account. Now I will supply my username, any username that I want to set. So suppose I am giving my name, my first name dot last name. Then I am giving a password. then I will confirm this password. Okay, so username can only contain letters and numbers. That's okay. I'm just giving my first name and last name. So I have given the password and confirmed the password. Now get started. Let's save. Okay, so it is launching my Snowflake trial account. Now our Snowflake account is launched. We are on this screen, so let's minimize this. We don't require this. And cancel. It is just giving us few options to learn Snowflake account, but I will just canceling it because I will be teaching everything that is there on this account. I will be covering each and every option that you are seeing here. So this is your Snowflake account. And now second thing is, go to your email again. Once you are on your email account, you can see that Snowflake is itself recommending that you should activate your account by clicking on this link within 72 hours of receiving your email. And the second thing I want you to note is this URL, because without this URL you cannot access your Snowflake account. So just copy this URL somewhere safe and secure and maybe handy, so that later on you can copy and paste this URL on your browser or just bookmark on your browser. So this way you can access your Snowflake account. So now we have launched our Snowflake account and we are ready to use it. So from the next lecture we will be starting exploring all the options that is there in Snowflake account.